leader with pipe playing. So we're jumping into the game. We're getting, it's like the knife round. And so always cool to see different knife skins. What skin do you have? Do you have a knife skin or?
I actually have a skin, a karambit, but I don't use it anymore.
Why not?
I don't feel like I deserve to use it.
Really? Why is that?
Because we lost a lot of games lately.
Oh, okay.
So I removed all my skins until we win again.
Really?
Yeah, motivation.
That is awesome. That is awesome. Are you into the whole like trading and betting thing with skins, or do you just open some cases just, every now and again? And
I open cases. I don't really bet since I've expressed my anger towards it. I don't want to bet and be a hypocrite.
So Zansmo going to do it. He just has to get three stabs. Think he's got this? Let's switch over to Asmo. Here he goes. One. Two. No! Oh, almost. Asmo trying to make the dream a reality.
As exciting as a knife run can be.
Yeah, pretty much. I've seen some exciting ones where you get the 1-on-4, 1-on-5 or whatever. That's cool, but yeah. So we will have our teams joining up on the sides that they choose. We have AliGon on CT. Alternate on the T side. And I imagine that this is going to be more difficult for AliGon on the CT side than it is the T side. So this is going to be this first half is really going to set the tone, I guess, of how the rest of the match is going to pan out. Because AliGon, they're going to have to put on some really nice defensive work here. And their communication is going to have to be really good. And that's maybe not the best, easiest thing in the mix. So let's see how they cope with it. So what are you seeing so far at the start here?
Seems like they're going for a B split pretty slow with a smoke window, and they're pushing B really fast now. And I'm not sure who's holding there. It's HMP and Xello. Xello's already tagged up. They're pushed. They actually have the site without them even taking duels. XR, HMP trading at one kill each.
It's very, very hard to get in here. They're doing a really good job at holding them off, but they are taking a fair amount of damage. But they did finally get the bomb down. But look at this AliGon actually finding their way into the site. Slowly but surely getting more and more position in that bomb site. Does take down a couple more players. And let's see what else they can do. Pipe coming in from the top here. And it looks like that was it. The cleanup, the retake, it worked. And I thought Ultimate actually had that for quite a while.
Yeah, I thought as well they played the afterplan situation the last map, they would have gotten that round, but AliGon just barely made the headshot work. They had like 10 HP, 20 HP, and it got the right kills at the right time, and it kind of went into a domino effect in the retake. So well played, AliGon, taking the first pistol round, really important. And we see Alternate going for kind of a B rush, maybe. We'll see.
And look at this, the P90. This could just mow them all down. Or actually, are they traveling down underpass here now, it seems? So, gonna see some happiness coming in onto B right now, because it is in the form of eco frags. Pro 90 at work. Just jump shooting with the Pro 90. Let's go! But Alternate, they use two players. Solik did actually manage to pick himself up an M4 here, which is pretty awesome. And Delpan going down to that nice little underpass push from Alternate did actually work out. And with this M4, they could accomplish surprisingly a lot of things. Let's see if Solik's able to do much. He is alone, though, which is not great. If he does go down, no teammates to pick up the weapon. But here they are, moving in towards B. Solik, will he be able to find a frag here? It's going to be very crucial to allow his teammates in onto that site. But look at this setup from AliGon. It's really good on the B. Bombsite Solik checking every angle. He's going to spot one, but Zelos is going to take him down. HMP over at Forest is ready to deal with this defense here. Ooh, ooh. Does get tagged.
HMP with 12 HP behind Forest. Basically, that was a really good eco from Alternate again, because they didn't buy that armor, so they can buy this round. So getting two guns, getting AliGon's money really, really low, so this is a really crucial round. If Ultimate takes this, AliGon has to eco. So, yeah, well played on the eco from Alternate setting up for this round.
Looks like they're going to be going in onto the A side here. They're all setting up there, waiting for that smoke to dissipate before finally chucking theirs over into positions, over at Connector, over to CT Spawn. There goes the counter flash from Pyth. He's going to need his teammates to help him flash those guys as well. Does take down one player. The bomb falls, and they are just dropping like flies in front of Pyth. No entry. Pyth shouts, you shall not pass. There's one more left over at the T slope, but they've done the job here. There's nothing really for Alex to be able to do here. He's just going to try to get a kill, perhaps, because that's all he's really got in him. And it looks like Zealous will take him out. And they only lost Zealous there. That was a really, really nice hold.
Yeah, it's the power of mixes towards set strats. It's you kind of play like really random positions. You play aggressively and you play to take the duels. And Pive anti-flash, dodged the flashes and had a great position as they pushed up slope through the smoke. So yeah, really good hold from AliGon. And instantly when they saw the smokes, they just instantly rotated and got the perfect defense.
Zealous to find some heads over here, over at B house as they try to make their way in, just running and gunning. They have no expectation other than death at this point. A plant would be wonderful, but that's just not going to happen. Alternate getting just absolutely mauled over in the B apps. Zealous pushing in. So pretty nice and tidy cleanup here. They only lost Pipe, so that's good.
Looking for that CZ on the ground, running around.
Oh yeah.
Important gun to have. It's actually so strong, it's like if you meet Pasha with that, it's like Pasha with an AWP and CZ is like he's having dual wielding an AK and an AWP.
Dude, I mean, Kadium is telling me constantly like how the CZ is the AWP's best friend. Like that's like the best pistol for an AWP. And I can really see why it's pretty darn good. And I like that little pop flash there, getting himself into one to pass. Is Solik. So AliGon with a crazy good start here, but they are up against the AKs once again of Alternate, who are working middle. And I really like how AliGon are kind of giving up middle. They're just playing short, they're playing connector. They're not putting anyone in on that CPL area. And that is pretty nice. It's
they have the information that is it Sevez who's down in the apps towards the spawn? So they know they can't come up. Imagine he's pushing really aggressively and gets taken out by Crystal on catwalk.
Looks like they are going to make their way into B now. I mean, there goes Nates. And I think AliGon are catching on to this. I think, again, that as you said, that aggressive push here from Pyth from behind is really what gave him the information. But he's not ready for Felix. Felix will take him out. And now they know exactly what's going on. But there's only two of them to defend against it. So it's going to be tough. Zealous's position, though, is really strong. Can he get the frag? He does manage to take him down. It's a 2-on-1 now. Also, Zevez chiming in with a kill onto Crystal. So Felix, he's the last man standing. And this is really starting to get away from Alternate. They really need Felix to come out huge here. This one over at Forest, he does get dinked pretty bad. And there goes the nade, not going to be enough. Felix goes down, and that's 5-0. That's starting to get out of control here.
Yeah, they were really undecided what to do in that 3-on-2. The bomb went towards A as 2 pushed towards B, 1 shore and 1 B apps. And yeah, he kind of just switched away when he was T-spawned, like, I can't go alone, eh? And they really unsynced push towards B, where they could have gotten Xelos and gotten an opening kill to the site. But really well played from Xelos, and yeah, they lost an entry, Asmo lost, and disconnected for a while, I guess it sticks in some lag. As he stated before, 5-on-4 now.
It does look kind of like they want that B split, but I'm not incredibly sure at the moment. I'm not sure if they're sure exactly what they're looking for just yet. Looking for the picks first. They do get one. Oh, HMP caught out over it short. He's going to get dropped, and this is looking really, really good now. Zealous has got to hold it down over at B there. Charging in. He's doing a great job. Gets the first headshot onto Alex, and he gets a lot of damage onto Felix as well. Zealous definitely putting the stop in, but the bomb is just over it. T spawn, and what are they going to do here? It's just looking terrible for them. Felix is in there.
Felix got to get this kill, otherwise it's going to be really tough.
This is looking very bad.
Pipe comes in with the support, and now they're two towards B and Crystal. Yeah, he knows that, and he just jolos on the ground and tries to get a pick on A.
And Sevis
is hiding with 1 HP.
Oh, he's in shadow. Crystal, find him. There we go. But Sevis going to get him. 6-0. And I almost wonder if AliGon, I mean, they're experienced players. They know that Alternate are able to buy every round now. But they're going to be low on nades because they have the consecutive round loss bonus. So, I mean, I think we saw that last round as well. There was like maybe four nades in total for their entire team with a full buy. So, so I guess you're going to be thinking that, all right, they're probably going to be looking to make these fast pushes. Alternately, though, they're still playing this kind of slow game, though, even though they have so few grenades.
I think what Alternate, they could have bought this round, but they're going for an eco instead to maybe pick up an AWP to change their game plan a bit. And I think that's the right choice. Crystal got a lot of entries against Mouseports last time with the AWP, so that could be very beneficial for them. And they actually did a really good eco, getting two people, almost three guys. And yeah, and now they have the money to buy an AWP if they want to. I would be surprised if they didn't, but...
Yeah. Let's have a look. There it is. Your prediction is correct. Crystal with that AWP, is he going to be challenging a mid, or is he... I mean, I guess they can't really think that there's going to be an aggressive play from AliGon so far, so just going to go straight up. First angle, connector. Not brave enough to peek. And actually look on the minimap, we can see AliGon pushing T-Slope kind of aggressively there. They're going to get the information real quick. They should know exactly what's going on in this round at the moment. And... Ultimate, they're still playing it really slow, though.
Yeah, Delpon getting the pick off B. I'm not sure if he spotted the bomb, but it seems like it, since Pyth is kind of rotating, and they pushed one T spawn already. Might catch Felix off guard. Oh. And he does. HMP gets the kill and backs off to safety. A smart play. And they kind of know it's a B push now.
So Asmo and Crystal, just the last dudes left alive. There you go, finally goes down. Oh, pops off HMP's head with that AK there. But the problem is that the bomb's all the way over here. They have to play for the fake now. And this is going to be a bit fishy. I think AliGon already suspect what's happening here. I think there's one player, there's Pyth. Very, very good game sense there to realize what was going on. It's almost too easy to just crap yourself and charge over towards A, where you lost the two players. But good hold there from Pyth, and now they know, they saw the bomb. Asmo, he has 20 seconds. He's going to have to start moving pretty quick if he wants to make this happen, or it's a question of just going for the save. Oh, wow, gets the first kill onto Pyth. Delpan is the last man left here now. 10 seconds, so he's going straight for the bomb. He's spotted Delpan. Delpan's caught out in the open. Can Asmo get the frag? He's looking at it. Can he get it? He does, and he gets it with 3 seconds left. Delpan caught in the worst possible position. Asmo... What a clutch from him.
The magic reconnect.
Yeah, I mean, that was so needed for them. But imagine if they lose this round. They lose their money round, but their consecutive money loss.
This is a really crucial round. They only survived one guy, and that was Asmo clutching that round. And if they lose now, they're going to be in deep, deep trouble. Because they're not going to have... money at all. Solek gets a guy off guard, Delpan, who's running with the off, kind of rotating from the mid link. And Alternate is getting really good map control at the moment. Seems like AliGon is playing more passively.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, only one, like Delpan was kind of peeking mid alone from connector, no crossfire from short or anything, so. It actually feels like B's pretty open here, but actually HMP is in the ladder room. He does pick off Crystal, and the bomb is dropped there. He knows it. He's calling to his teammates. There go the flashes, perfectly handled by HMP. That bomb is still just sitting there, and his team now knows exactly what's up. So Delpan's still really weak. He's got to be thinking about just letting the rest of his teammates handle this. Does not want to drop that AWP. And HMP, look at this. What a great position.
This could be disastrous. One is in jungle. When they get up Sevis, HMP, great round from him, gets the triple kill, and Alex R and Asmo left alone, and bomb is dropped in a very, very weird position for them.
Asmo going to go for the first frag. There comes the Soul, barely not getting the second. Alex, though, he knows what's up, and there is a player in the ladder room. There's two of them with less than five health. Five or less. Pyth is still fully stacked. And it's going to go down. Oh, what a... Just that bomb drop, I mean, that just ruined them.
That was a quad kill from HMP in the ladder room. So, amazing round from him. Getting the two entries with the bomb drop, so they actually knew where Alternate would rotate and push. Really, really saved them, or got them the round there. I mean, it was still close. HMP had like 4 HP and Delpan had 2. So... in a 1-on-3 situation, and alternate going for that eco with the C-Sedge again.
And this is that horrible thing that happens, and I don't know, have you guys ever considered maybe forcing these situations? Your opponents, you've won so many rounds in a row, so your opponents are being able to buy every round. You're just like, let's just give one away, so then, because now they're screwed on money, like they've lost, they just get no money anymore, so they have to eco again, so it's just, oh, it's
like,
so horrible.
I guess it's more of a way, if you get like 7 rounds in a row, you kind of make it like it's okay to lose that round because we have the amazing opportunity to actually, if we get them this round, it's going to be awesome for us.
Yep.
You know, they're going to be so screwed on money. And wow, Asmo's actually on 8k money.
Wow, he's setting up a little bank over there. That's pretty nice.
I'm surprised they didn't went for the AWP. I guess they're waiting. No?
Interesting.
This is a weird buy. 2 C-Sets and 3 AKs.
Interesting stuff here coming in from Ultimate. And to be honest, they've got to be grasping at straws at this point. They're definitely desperate. With only one round on the board, what they did to Mouse Sports is now being done to them in kind on Mirage. Yep. They're having their comeuppance from the Swedish mix team. And they know what's happening.
Yeah, they pushed up mid and they know it's an A push. They got all 5 members towards A. And 1 from behind for holding sight. So this is going to be disastrous for Alternate.
Oh, this is going to be so, so bad. They're going to rush in right now into all the players. But Asmo is pushed really far up. They do get a couple kills, but it's just Crystal left with the AK. He is just running and gunning through smoke. It's not going to happen. Easy cleanup from AliGon. That aggressive push, that just sealed the deal for them. They just knew straight away.
Yeah,
that's
seems
so
to be Alternate weakness overall that they don't really have the map control needed to make those pushes if they make them too often.
Right, right.
They need to push them back. AliGon cannot be allowed to push A, B, or mid whenever they want. They need to have guys holding the places and getting the kills when they do those pushes. Because that was really early push. I mean, it was like 15 seconds into the round and they were already up mid and already calling the rotation.
I love the very defensive setup from AliGon right now. It actually reminds me a little bit of VODS Pro's setup on the defense on this map. They have a similar thing going on A and B. Yeah. You know, just kind of giving up mid. If there's an AWP on the other team, they force them to close range and they can use their grenades better. It's really, really effective. And we can see right now that Alternate are kind of struggling to know what to do right here.
Even though there was no one holding mid, they're really afraid of taking mid because of those early pushes in the beginning. Dalpan gets the frag in middle, I guess.
Oh, and Zelos with a good Molotov there. They do smoke the car. They're going to be able to go through that smoke, but Zelos, he spotted a lot of players. They know what's up. Again, they're getting the rotations in. They've left one over at A just in case of any shenanigans. But here is Zelos right at the back. Good angle. Going to take down Alex. HMP to cut down Felix. Crystal falls in turn as well.
Alternate seem kind of clueless right now. They're pushing, making the push, but it's almost too obvious. So AliGon, they always have the info where they're going. So they're 3 or 4 people everywhere they're going. If they're going B, there are 4 people there. If they're going A, like last round, there were 5 people there. I mean, something's got to change. They have to maybe slow it down and hold the map control for a while and then rotate to a push.
Right, right. I think that's actually one of those situations which is a very, very good, this is not how you do it kind of moment where, because Counter-Strike's about information, right? It's like decision. Yeah. How do you make a decision? Well, you take the information you have and then you create the best decision from that. And so they're just giving information so easily to AliGon so they can just make the best calls. And then CT is always, that's the battle for CT, is just get the info. And Dalpan opening things up with a quick kill there over at mid, which is really nice. They're taking control of mid again.
I think AliGon even knows this is going to be an A split. They're pushing aggressive mid, trying to take the information. See, there's like no one towards B and everyone's towards mid and A.
Nice frag from Asmo, but they are on a bit of a half buy again. Just like a Glock there for Crystal and a Deagle for Felix. They're going to need to try to fix that as soon as possible. They do have a man advantage here, though. They are regrouping towards A.
Alex actually has the bomb in mid. This could be really dangerous for alternate, even if they get the entry on A site.
This is really, really awkward here for alternate. They're moving in on A, and another great kill coming in from Asmo. He's just making the round work for them so far. But can they get that bomb in through connector? That's the big challenge for them right now. Telos is over there. He's going to take down Felix. Again, Alex trying to get up those stairs, trying to get himself safely over to the bomb spot. And wow, Asmo's finally getting picked off. It's just Alex left with that AWP, and this is so awkward. He's going to try to get something happening here, going for a bit of a no-scope, nothing going on for him. He can't get the bomb down. There's so much pressure from CT spawn and from connector. Yep. Goes for the fake, but there's just no time.
And the awkward positioning of the bomb actually being in mid, they had to focus mid Link and try to defend him as he pushed towards site. And it, I mean, that opened up spawn to get kills. So it's really unfortunate that they got the entry A, and they actually hold A site, but the bomb is in a, such a bad position. They have to like refocus and try to get him up to A instead of just planting the bomb and having an after plant situation with a man up.
Definitely, and Delpan is just taking control of mid again, pushing up. There goes the nades. A bit of a delayed push into mid. Delpan's position is fairly exposed, but he does hit the most crucial shot. They can't push in on top of him anymore. As Delpan is getting flashed again, they're going to try to make something happen. They're going towards B, but it's actually Zelos with a couple kills over here. And Delpan does get taken out, so they have a man pushing up short now. So you can see them making their way in. It's just Asmo left again. He has done some great stuff so far, but he cannot do it all alone. And he's 1-4. This scoreline is just...
And I think AliGon knows where the bomb is, so... Yeah, I think it's going to be 13-1, and that's really, really bad for alternate. Asmo's doing work, though. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, three players left to take down for Asmo. They're just shooting in on top of him from all angles at this point. So, you're telling me, okay, I think AliGon's going to win. Did you think that they were going to be doing quite the result we're seeing here?
I think their CT side would have been like really strong because of their individual skill and how they take the decision to go aggressive and when. And it seems, as I said before, to be alternate's kryptonite. Go aggressive, don't let them do the strats, and yeah.
It is working pretty damn well. It's like you had a good read on it. It's like got a lot of stuff happening over here. Just HMP and Zelos left now. See, good position from Zelos. Dolls dropped the bomb there. HMP also gets a kill. Gonna flash out for HMP to get away, and also, ooh, might be able to take him down. He's so low. Zelos trying to save himself, but he's caught out. HMP can make this happen. Crystal's super low. Alex and Asmo picked up the bomb now.
I think he's catwalk. Now they know where he is. They shouldn't be able to lose this. With three entries and then one on three now.
Nice. That's a nice little position there. Very cute stuff. And end of the first half, 13-2. It could all just blow up in one round now. Just that one pistol round. That's all AliGon need to win. And pistol rounds, I mean, I'm definitely going to say that they're going to have an advantage going in on the pistol. I mean, as you said, you know, the individual skills are so good. And they're probably just going to Glock train it up somewhere and just cause havoc. I want to see a Glock train.
I think they're going towards a B. Might be... Who's going A? Delpan. Is Delpan going A? Or is... Not sure who has the nades. No, Delpan is mid with the nades. They're going 3 mid. No, 3 B, 1 mid, and 1 A app. And seems like alternate wants a pause in the middle of the game. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, perhaps experiencing some problems that we haven't seen, but either way, AliGon are playing pretty damn well, and they are taking this really slowly at the beginning of this pistol round for the second half, and
seems like they want to like fake an A split.
Just going for some distraction over here on A, as the rest of AliGon move through the apartments over at B. Solik in a good spot. It gets flashed. Oh, he's a bit... Oh, not able to get any kills with that. That is definitely really, really nasty to see. And Zevis going to make his way through. Does gun down Alex. But actually, they're making some good trades here. Zevis, though, on a rampage with a second frag. And Asmo there taking the jewel. Does get the headshot onto Zelos. pretty crucial there. That puts it to a 2-on-2.
Dalkan's got a great position. And yeah, he takes out Felix and can hold that position forever.
Oh,
he should be able to.
That's Mo goes down.
That's a really smart play by AliGon, though. They kind of held the rotations, so they were always free on A. And since they got the trade, the first kill on B, they could take the site easily, and the other two players didn't really count. It was like a 1-on-1 versus a 1-on-1 with Delpan in mid lurking and Xelos jumping out of A abs. So
yep.
They kind of forced the 3 versus 2 towards B as T, which is fine. You know, they got a good flash on the first one and just popped him down.
So did you like the way that AliGon took the first pistol round there? Or rather, sorry, their pistol round?
Yeah, I mean, they kind of alternate seem to be really, really defensive based. They don't take the aggressive pushes. So Delpan could free roam middle for a bit. He smoked CPL, kind of faked the...
I've had that bug. Asma's complaining that he couldn't buy with the mouse, and it annoyed him too much. So that's why they paused. That's nice to see, because usually the pause means DDoS incoming or something. Yeah. That's a lot better.
That's the best pause. But yeah, I really liked how they kind of delayed the rotation towards B at the same time as they pushed, which could have spiraled out of control, but... they played it smartly and survived for a long time. So, yeah, I like that.
All right, so we are going to go to the unpause now. And alternate, they may not be in this game for too much longer, losing that pistol round on an eco.
I do think their CT side could be really good against AliGon's T side, depending on how well they coordinate. They had really good team play with flashes, etc. So... if they only can win this round and actually get guns and nades, I can see alternate making a comeback, but it's gonna be really, really tough. Obviously, they're down 14-2.
I wanna see their CT against AliGon, but that's the big question: is it can they make it that far? Okay, so we do have 5-7 on Crystal, best pistol. Oh yeah. I love me the 5-7. And AliGon playing the safe standard round at the moment, the safe standard anti-eco, just chilling in mid, taking those long-range battles if they can find them. Crystal.
Going up mid link with no support at all. That's really important kill by Crystal, as Asmo's tagging up Xelos really bad. The T-spawn.
Nice stuff there, actually. It's a really good start to Ultimate's eco situation here.
I just hope that they get the information that they're sneaking here early, because there's so many towards A, but they're making the pushes underground and they're making the rotation now. They know. Five takes out Solek. They have the B site, but they have good rotation CT, so this could be good for them. As Crystal takes out Xelos. It's a 3-on-3 now, but Xelos is really low. Crystal takes him out. Two pushing short as CT and one retaking from Kitchen.
And goes Asmo. Did he just get tagged by a teammate? I think he did. And there's Lars Eric Carr, and he doesn't have much health left. And it's just a 1-on-1 Crystal. Oh, and he makes it happen. He has time. He's going to get the defuse. And ultimate.
One kill from Crystal in the retake. That was really good. He got the first kill on Delpan, picked up a gun, and his mates baited for him, took the information where they were. For example, him in B-Abs. He took a duel against him, the T, holding B-Abs, and Crystal went up short and killed him, revenge fragged him. So, really well played, even though they had small amounts of equipment to deal with that situation.
And we actually see Zevas and Pais with pistol armor and some nades on Xelos. So I wonder if this is indicative of just like hard A push that we're starting to see get set up. And this could be really, really annoying here for Alternate on, you know, some weak weapons, some Famases in the mix. Let's see if they're able to defend here. Felix right at the back towards CT spawn. They are picking up the frags though. Asmo's position still good at Shadow. Takes down two. There's just HMP left. Looks like they did the job. So it's all, they can calm down a little bit. Only lost one guy. Still, though, I mean, they can't lose any rounds at all, but at least their money is starting to build a little bit.
Yeah, and I mean, AliGon has so many rounds to play. They could basically just force buy all the rounds and probably still get the rounds they need. I mean, getting... like, losing 10 rounds in a row, like, they're even then. So, I mean, they got a lot of rounds to play with. So, let's see how Alternate and their nades and flashes for each other in team play is going to pan out here on the CT side.
Again, we just see, you know, mid control getting taken by the Swedish mix as they are looking for those picks. Those AKs can be really dangerous against these Phalanxes. Oh, even the Galil coming in there as Zevis just walks up T-slope, takes control, and Zelos in a very far push position at ladder. That catches Alex by surprise, and all of a sudden, it is a 3-on-5. Make that a 3-on-3, Crystal and Felix. They are able to even things up. Delpan, a little bit of an awkward duel here in the smoke. They're both just praying for their lives, and Delpan makes that one work. 2-on-2 now. Things are very, very tense here for Alternate. They cannot afford to lose this. There's just no... there is no world in which that can happen for them and be okay.
AliGon is taking it really slow, but they have a really good position. I mean, they're in the middle of the map. They can basically go anywhere they want. And the CTs have no information on it. They know they're around there, but they can basically take every round. And Xelos picks up Solek, and they have free entrance to B, and they know Felix was on A, so... they know how to defend this.
Felix coming in with the Galil. Has no head armor, although that doesn't really matter against the AKs, but here he is creeping in, one at Forest, one on the site. He's gonna catch him. Good stuff from Delpan on the angle. And that is 15-4. AliGon crushing their way through the German squad here on Mirage.
Yeah, and I don't have high hopes for Alternate right now. I mean, they're basically broke. They're scrambling for nades. It's looking really bad. And oh, Felix takes a gamble and wins. Good job, Felix. Maybe this can sort things out for them. Play the entries. They're going aggressive again. Not sure I like this.
Oh, HMP, he's... to a really nice angle here. He might just be able to deal with Solek. Solek, though, he's still alive. And trying to find another angle there and move his way to safety, as we are going to see a boost here, it looks like. Pi's going to boost his mate up into CPL. Alternate will be attacked from all sides very soon. Solek, good position there. And it looks like AliGon are just holding things for now, regrouping a little bit, going to pick up that bomb and take it towards short, it looks like, for now. And Alternate can still make this happen. They just have to get these first frags, and then they're going to be good. Solek.
Seems like a B split is panning out. HMP gets Solek, who had a great position. Now the rotation is late. They don't know how many is out, and all of them is towards B right now.
I don't know if they're going to have a chance to get this bomb down. There goes the peek onto the planter. They do take him out. Felix, though, on the side, does grab the kill onto Pythe as they make their way forward. He's got to try to buy time for his mate to get there to help him out. There's no nades left for them, though, and he does take down HMP. It's a 1-on-1, and Felix coming out huge in that round to save the day for Alternate. But this is quite a climb. They need to win 10 in a row to tie this up for overtime. That is ridiculous.
Yeah, especially with the AliGon negating the fact that they cannot be money fucked, as I like to call it, anymore. I mean, they can force buy every round. NST with, like, one smoke, one flash, and full armor AK, it's not as bad as CT with low nades.
And Zevis going to just walk up connector, looking for some shots, some info. He's not going to find anything. And it's just an eco for AliGon. They can just, you know, just do whatever.
They're just saving up money towards getting the
that was
bonus.
Awesome. Delphan thought maybe he could catch him with a nade out, then fought twice, but already it was too late. And it's like, couple kills are coming onto alternate. They really can't afford to lose any men. Their money is so bad still. Like they didn't even have a full buy this round. It's not looking great for them here.
Their money is still really bad. I'm not sure if everyone can buy up fully. Doesn't seem like it.
What happened there? There we go.
Adding Solik to friends.
It's pretty good. Yeah. Pretty good. And we're seeing another Eka coming in here. We haven't seen any. I think Alternate are desperate for an AWP or something, or just something. Something that costs actual money because they've been without it for so long.
I like that AliGon are actually going for a double Eco, so they have a lot of money to play with.
Here we go, making their way in. The Eagle Sniper, not good enough. Alternate to take another round. And I don't know, I want to believe. I want to believe, Devilhawk, I really do. But
it's going to be really tough. Now the AWP is picked up by Solik. Really not sure. I've seen three different AWPers in, I think. I think Alex R and Solik and Crystal have been AWPing this day. It's really weird. But anyways, they have the AWP in B apps, and hopefully they can get the entry with, I think HMP has been really aggressive there, so that may be the reason why they're picking up the AWP.
They do have someone pushed into underpass, it looks like. If we can find him.
Seems like they're kind of working their way towards an A split, but you never know. Sevis gets the entry in slope again. Asmo's been handled the trouble there, as they kind of have A already. This is really weird. They just walked up mid link and got A.
Yeah, I don't really know what happened there. I mean, they have a couple players low at least for Alex to try to clean up, but this already looks incredibly bad. Alex is going to have to play the round of his life to take this one back. And he's actually going to get the first frag onto Zevis. There's three left standing in the A bomb site. The bomb is going to get planted any second, I'm sure of it. Oh, lots of damage taken there. Alex peeks out for a moment. I think that was a regrettable decision at this point. Goes for the flash out, but Delpan chops his head off. 16-7, another dominant performance on Mirage, but this